Alright, hey, hi, everybody, this is Pika here, and I'm back with some more rewrite, and this is gonna be part 3. Alright, so basically what happened last time was that we met a few interesting folks. That's the word, right? I mean, aside from, like, you know, the friend request people, we met the new transfer student who we know as Otori. And we met this guy, who we don't know the name of, officially, but his name is Imamiya Arata. So, let's get started. I was hoping to record this actually on Sunday night, it's still Saturday. But no, people were not online. So I got bored. Alright. The alarm clock rings. Half asleep, I unleash an attack upon the source of the noise and it stops. I wake up. I sleep. Get your ass up! And that's why I was almost late today. Oh, hi, Kotori. It happens sometimes. She hands me a mirror. I didn't have time to fix that. I better go to the bathroom later and straighten it. Hey, Yoshino! I was gonna call you Haruhiko! Suddenly I notice Yoshino staring at me with his arms folded, leaning back in his chair. What? You don't want to join our fun morning conversation? Okay. The usual reaction. I'll have to give up on having an intimate talk with Yoshino for now. He does? Yoshino lowers his eyes and acts uninterested. I think I know what you mean. He'd be the one cutting through steel. Your mouth loosened up a bit. Are you happy? Okay. The teacher comes in after the bell, but the students keep talking instead of returning to their seats. Everyone's talking about the same thing. The transfer student who was supposed to arrive yesterday. Her chair and desk were procured yesterday, but they're still sitting in the corner without an owner. The teacher could probably tell that's what they were talking about, so he didn't scold anyone. Maybe the teacher's just putting on a weird show. If the teacher's plan is to have the transfer student arrive when everyone's eager to meet her, then it's working perfectly on Kotori. Well, I did meet her yesterday. Well, all I did was bump into her on the hill and guide her to the staff room. Wait. I didn't do the second part! So I've only seen her in the staff room so far. She's not gonna like me much, though. Yeah, sorry, but I didn't escort her. If anything, I made her hate me in less than half an hour. Okay, everyone, please sit down. Let's get started. The teacher looks around as if the time is ripe.
Hi.
Yoshino's lying face down on his desk. Hey, Yoshi, wanna hear about the transfer student? This guy needs to get some ass in his life. So what do you want me to say? You want me to call you by your first name, Haruhiko? I want to tell him that lying on the bed sounds rather erotic, but that changed the topic too much. You say that, but you still want to know, don't you? I can tell. But don't you want to know just a little? How did you feel when we called you a samurai? He's really mad. Oh, or say. What the fuck is this? What the hell's Orisei? To be honest, are you ever going to do that? Because you're just pissing me off. with this whole like back and forth. Yoshida-kun, please try to keep it down. We're starting homeroom, so shut the fuck up. He starts taking roll as usual, but the classroom can't quite calm down. Everyone's on the edge of their seats about the transfer student. Now I'll introduce the transfer student. Sorry to make you wait a whole day for this. Everyone, let's greet her with a round of applause. Oh, I can't do that, says the whole class. Even Yoshino's looking at the door now. Okay, transfer student, come in! The classroom becomes even more excited. Oh boy. The transfer student Otori-san enters quietly. It doesn't feel interesting anymore since I've met her already. I look to one side. Yoshino's face is on his desk again. He must have been satisfied after seeing her face. Look, Yoshino Totori-san, the transfer student! Denoji-kun, no spoilers! Sorry. Crap, now everyone's annoyed at me for ruining the mood. So as for Otori-san... Uh-oh. Just like, Denoji. Oh, crap. She is not gonna be happy to know she's in my homeroom. She doesn't say it this time, but she makes the gif face again. And now she's glaring at me. Introduce yourself to everyone! Basically, I forgot that this is the same teacher I introduced Chihaya to, so... That felt a little forced. And she seems disgusted by me. Yay. Pleased to meet you! But the boys all seem to think she's just tense, so they aren't bothered by it. Honestly, Otori does look cuter than the average girl. People do tend to expect something exceptional from transfer students, even though 99% of them are ordinary. Little Wallace guy over here has no interest in her. Hey Yoshino, Otori sounds pretty cute. You sure? That was blunt. At least you're different. You only like ugly women anyway. So you're gay? People around us began whispering, Yoshino-kun's gay. A certain group of girls started giving us weird looks. Are these the BL loving girls, or is this the other way? Why both of us? Yes! Oh, we're still a couple! Come here! Yup! Crap! If you're gay, then I'm the only love interest! Crap! I bet there's people in this fucking fandom, in the rewrite fandom, who have just shipped this couple right from this point! Oh my god, I need cute fluffy art of these two now. I need it! Yoshino, can you seem weirdly familiar with this? Ow. He kicks me. I'm sorry. Also, there's been some difficulty getting her a new uniform, so she'll keep wearing this one for a while. Please don't pry about it. As for your seat, might as well use the one in the back until we have another seat change. But the seats at the back are... right behind us? Shit. What's wrong? Let her sit behind you so you can help her. She hates me after all. So what am I? She glances toward me. Then she looks at the hallway. I guess she wants a seat on that side. It's probably easiest to see from the center, so how about behind Tenojikun? Shit. Otori starts shivering. I have no idea what to do. She seems to hate me with a passion, so it wouldn't feel right for her to sit near me. And from my point of view, it isn't exactly pleasant to sit between her bloodlust and the transfer student fever. Maybe I should try to help Ultori here for both our sakes. I'm be fucking fortunately, they don't tell you what to do here. Alright, so we have to help her out. Yeah, we'll help her out. Okay, let's see what I can do. I move my seat back little by little. This is my huh? Actually, there isn't much space behind Tennoji. Let's try somewhere else plan. Oh, okay. If it works, all Tori has to do is say, I'd like to seat near the hallway. Ah, come to think of it, there doesn't seem to be much space behind Tennoji-kun. It's working, sir. Then Yoshino-kun! Oh, you motherfucker! Yoshino smoothly moves his desk back a little, with his face still lying flat on his desk. Huh? Oh, well. It's working again, sir. You can sit next to Tennoji-kun. You seem to know each other already, so he can help you out.
Stop!
Damn it, she's dead set on putting her near me. Wait, what? What? Why are you two suddenly in sync? Actually, there is space behind me. I've moved my seat back. We're basically stuck either way, so you can either be next to me or behind me. She sighs and starts walking this way. I guess she gave up. She moves her chair and desk directly behind me. Yoshino-kun, please move your desk back too. Well, this sort of plan usually doesn't work. I'm glad the teacher was willing to play along with it, though. So here's the contact information and bullshit. The teacher starts writing something about a meeting in the corner of the blackboard. I can hear her put down the chair and desk behind me. I'll try saying something casually to her. Maybe she'll be easier on me now. I could try giving her a nickname right away, like in one of those old crime dramas. Let's see. Hey, Cherry!
Okay!
She picked up the desk with one hand. Oh, well, you don't need to go quite that far. She puts it back. Okay. Pleased to meet you too. Yoshino's a bit scared too. I bet he would, considering a girl just probably picked up a desk with one hand. It's hard to believe, but this transfer student is a high-level power fighter. I bet. When homeroom ends, the students immediately surround Ultori. Hey, where are you from? What are your hobbies? Will you join a club? Do you have a boyfriend? If not, I nominate myself! Most of the typical transfer student questions get thrown out. I doubt she'd get along with that last guy. It seems only Yoshino and I saw her super strength a moment ago. This is pretty tiring, Yoshino-kun. Unable to leave his seat, Yoshino turns his back on the crowds. I'm completely engulfed, but fortunately for him, there's an empty space around his desk. I'm in extremely odd position here. I can't exactly join in the transfer student fever. I guess I'll go to the bathroom for now. Wanna come with me? Well, that's a normal reaction. It's not exactly her fault, though! I hear Yoshino muttering behind me. Is he trying to make me hear him on purpose? Well, I'll just ignore it for now. I didn't hear a thing. Just as I escape through the crowds, the door opens. Oh, perfect timing, Tennoji-kun! What is it? Ultori-san's textbooks have arrived in the staff room. Could you escort her there and show her around the school while you're at it? Me? Wait, why didn't you just bring the books here? Well, I forgot! Saying it with playful eyes doesn't help. I'm counting on you! Bye now, I've got another class to teach! Are you joking? No, can't you get some... She's already gone. I guess I was just the first guy she bumped into. I should ask someone else to do it. Not Yoshino, he's dead set on ignoring her. Which means... Come on! Man, stop giving me choice. Oh, oops. Oh, I was gonna say, it's like, what? Oh, God. Do I literally, like, have to choose who? Let's ask for her help. There is only one choice. Having friends really is important. Well, it's too late to regret it now. And then I realize Clotori's not here. Fuck! Where on earth could she be? Clotori does do a lot of stuff by herself. It's probably futile to ask where she went. Which means I have to do it. Great. Hey, I tried! I have no clue. My thoughts exactly. This is perilous. I can feel constant pressure coming from Altori behind me. Well, I still have to show her around. Altori-san, this is 2B's classroom. Okay. Good point. The conversation ends. We proceed in silence. Our footsteps sound really loud in the hallway. We really shouldn't be fighting this much so soon after our first meeting. Maybe I should apologize. No, I'm pretty sure I haven't done anything wrong. So what is it then? Bad chemistry? I probably did make fun of her a bit more than I should've. Okay. Hey, Altori. I actually feel really bad about what happened. And my attitude hasn't been great either. I'll try to fix it, so... I turn around. Sorry! I lower my head. She's gone! Wait, what? Where'd Altori go? Hey, Altori! I go back to the previous corner and see her running down a different corridor. God damn it! I wanted to ask you that! How do you get lost when following behind me? Ouch. Apparently a similar thing happened behind me. Well, I'm not doing this on purpose. She's glaring at me so hard. Apologizing right now isn't a good idea. Let's go. She points out the window. Where? I look out the courtyard in the gym. Yeah, that's the gym. It does have kind of a weird shape, but the inside's pretty normal. There you go, you're smiling! Wait, suddenly things are going a lot better. There we go, I mean, things are getting better. Sure. So her curiosity just outweighed her hatred of me. Wait, I'm checking something here. Okay. I was like, at first I thought like I was misshaping the screen. I feel like I've completely missed the right time for something. Can we do more mappy segments, please? We approach the stairs. Watch your feet, huh? Altori was gazing out the window. You're so easily distracted. This is probably how we got separated before. What is it this time, transfer student? Yeah, I guess. I open the window. Altori leans out a little. She gasps as the wind blows and making her hair float up. You might want to step back a little so that way you know you don't fall out. Yeah, Kazumatsuri is all about forestation. I look out the window too. I've lived in this town my whole life, so it's pretty ordinary to me. It must look invigorating for someone like Goldori. The forest just feels like a part of the town. Especially down there at the bottom of the hill. That place is completely covered in trees.
Hi!
When I was a kid, there was a concrete building there. Then it burned down or something. They left the place alone for a while, but after a year they started planting stuff. And now the whole area is overgrown. The land around here is probably ideal for growing plants. Every time they try planting something, it thrives and flourishes. There we go, we're starting to get along! I think the soil here is just good for growing stuff. Ah, that's a rural area. Our food is all made by the farmers out there. That was a little poetic. I've actually never seen the ocean. I've been in this town my whole life. Is it rare to see a landscape like this? Where do we live? Probably. I'm just used to this. Unfortunately, I always want to leave this town and be a city boy somewhere else. And yes, I'm fucking proud of it. And lots of people feel like that. People always want things they don't have. Though I do have some attachment to my childhood memories here. You seem to like this town a lot. I'm not sure. Eh? Fine. I start walking again. I might never be able to understand how someone from the outside world sees things here. This town is probably special. But it's all normal to me. That fundamental difference changes everything. There's no way for me to put myself in her shoes. Altori and I couldn't be a worse match. When I start living in another town, what will I think of that place? What if it's a seaside town? What if it's in the middle of a concrete jungle? What if I don't know a single person there?
Yeah!
You fell from the window, didn't you? Is there really a need for me to reconcile with the transfer student who just tripped on a can and fell down the stairs? Oh. Hey, you okay? She gets up. You're not hurt at all. That was a pretty impressive tumble. That sounds bad. Let me see it. Why would you ask that? She starts pulling her skirt up then freezes. Yeah! Exactly. She leaps up to her feet and stomps on the ground. Good question! She seems fine. She really is tough. Okay, though you're the one who wanted to stop. We're late enough as it is. This should be a quick tour. I grab Tori's hand. She pulls her hand back. It's safer if I hold on to you. Trust me. Look, it's either really bad luck or you're a fucking klutz. Either way, you're dangerous to be left alone. Oh, here we go. One, you get lost by walking in a straight line. Two, you fall all the way down the stairs for no apparent reason. And three, you've done similar things before. Seems like plenty of justification to me. Besides, we haven't seen anyone this whole time, so there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Okay. I pull Tori's wrist and start walking. Now I kind of feel like a babysitter. We get our stuff from the staff room and quickly return to class. Most of it was textbooks. Okay, let's go. I hold out my hand toward Tori.
Hey?
Hi! Just be careful. She hands me her stuff. Well, at least I can carry this. Now let's go back. I'll hold your hand again. I know you don't like it, but it's your fault for getting into trouble so easily. I can't let her get seriously injured after all. We walk back the way we came. Whoa. She stumbles on the stairs again. God damn it. You trip a lot. Well, this does prevent you from getting hurt. And thus we reached the classroom. Here we are. No problem. I can show you around whenever, just ask. I'm just saying. And that's how I escorted her safely back to the classroom. Though I'm not sure if I managed to bridge the gap between me and the transfer students. Well, you were managing to get along with her though, so that's good. During break time as I walk through the halls... Yes? That's me. A girl I don't know talks to me.
Inoue?
Okay. She makes a quick polite bow. Thanks. I bow too. I didn't know we had a newspaper club. Excuse me. I've never seen a newspaper here. It's possible to do club activities through school websites. We vote for student officials online. We can even write blogs or hold meetings online. But they're supposed to be for educational purposes, so we can't make blogs just about ourselves or anything. So, what does the newspaper club want with me? Or are you confessing your love? Inoue looks at me with cold eyes. You want to know more about me? Ask away. I'm single, by the way, so feel free to confess. You prick. Checking to see if the audio's working. Alright.
今までフリーじゃなかったことは?
Actually, no. If that makes you pity me, then pretend this is just the trial version. Try going out with me. Inoue writes something in her notebook. What are you writing? Hey.
ところで、ちょっと聞きたいことがあるんだけど。
I won't tell you anything personal. Also, I was joking earlier. I have a girlfriend.
カンベさんでしょ?
No. Does everyone really think that? It kind of hurts. So what was your question?
天王寺君、裏口入学したって本当?
Wait, what? You're pretty blunt. In fact, that's close to being rude.
どうなの?
I've never heard a rumor that stupid before. Is there even such a thing as illegal admission to high school? Inoue writes something down, making it as obvious as possible. Wait a minute. Why are you trying to make me sound bad? That's just mean. I got in by having decent grades. Go check your facts, dipshit. You're hearing this straight from the source. Why the fuck would I lie to you? That's just wrong. That's rather pitiful. Must be a pretty ridiculous newspaper. She hands me a light green plastic business card. Inoue's name is on it. It even has a QR code on it, so I can get straight to their website if I scan this. A school newspaper can afford this sort of thing? She sounds confident. I can't respect you for prying deeply into a perfectly innocent person's history. The classes suddenly got harder and I couldn't keep up. I don't remember having any trouble when taking the entrance exam. I'm being investigated! I start shivering. I take out my cell phone. I put her business card under my phone scanner. The scanner contains a powerful all-purpose sensor. It finishes the scan in under a second. This way I can access their site without typing a URL. Let's see what you've got. Mm-hmm. It looks like a proper website. It's well designed and easy to search. It does a good job of getting the feel of the school across, and there are plenty of videos and pictures. This will be a very useful page for anyone considering going to this high school. This is a good site. I better use some of this stuff for my part-time job. Anyway, so you're going to investigate my spotless history no matter what I say, right?
So させてもらうわ。近いうちに必ずカツ丼をおごってみせるわ。
God, you're like fucking paparazzi. You met in Inoue! Still, people take their clubs pretty seriously. I'm a little jealous, actually. Clubs, work, a part-time job writing articles, the newspaper club? Something connects. As if to prevent me from finishing that thought, a piece of paper falls from the business card. A receipt? Inoue special memo. If anyone sees it, the government will try to kill them. Crap, she's insane. She's completely lost it. She's beyond all help. This is embarrassing the Earth in front of the entire universe. Actually, I'm curious. Here we go! Yes, I knew it. Inoue, a reporter girl in the Kazumatsuri Academy Newspaper Club. Her nickname is Inoue. She's liked cup ramen ever since she saw footage of the Osama Sanso incident, 1972, where riot police had to eat it outside. What? It's best I don't get involved, but I can't hold back my curiosity. This is Pika's having trouble trying to pronounce the word suspicious. There we go. List of suspicious. Fucking shit. List of suspicious people. There we go. Third year witch Senri Akane, president of the Occult Research Club, has tremendous authority far beyond that of a normal student. Extremely dangerous to approach, need a careful plan. Second year gray boy Tanoji Kotaro. Many suspicious details in this history. No one seems to be backing him. Direct investigation may be effective. Second year Messiah Tanuma Imako might be the Messiah. Is there a gag law in effect? Need to question his doctors. First year scissor girl Shin Saibashi Hitomi might have been held back a year. Has high athletic ability but refuses to join any sports teams. Transferred on September 1st, no explanation given. Why is my name here? This is an eccentric list. Several people are on it. It's overwhelming. But this is the reason Inoue contacted me. I guess illegal acceptance is what she got out of my suspicious history. It's just a rumor. I shove the list into my pocket. It'd be bad if she finds out I picked it up. I'll get rid of it later. No, wait. I open it up again. As I feared, there are comments next to some of these entries. I didn't notice it before, but Inoue's crossed the line. This is bad. There aren't any special comments next to my entry, so she probably hasn't found out yet. But I can't risk her sniffing around. Gotta be careful. I warn myself. Huh. Hey. Katori peeks over my shoulders as I study Inoue's memo. I have no clue. It's my street name. Think of it like a nickname. They come up a lot in games, you know? Kojiro of the Flames or Leonhart the Supersonic. I don't know. It's just stupid. There's no reason for it. The witch? You mean Senri Akane? Third year witch Senri Akane. President of the Occult Research Club has tremendous authority far beyond that of a normal student. I had no idea. What's the Occult Research Club? So some of this information is actually true? Does that mean Inoue might already know my secret? I'm worried now. I finally started to forget about it. It took a lot of work to get this far. If people found out about it and started a commotion... Mi Dios.
wakatta?
Kotori, didn't you used to say don't leave my beehive when you meant don't leave me behind?
Sonna koto itte ta kke?
Her face glows red. You did. It was cute.
Yose yoi. Aho da na, mukashi no atashi. Aho!
Ho-ho! I satisfy myself with Kotori's shame. So what's the Senri person like?
有名だけど、表舞台には出てこない人だね。裏社会のドンとか、学園の魔女だとか、いろいろ言われてる。
Is witch meant as an insult?
怖がられてるんだよ。
Doesn't that mean they just find her creepy? There's a big difference in nuance.
本当に怖がられてる。 恐怖されてる。
Because she has so much authority?
その人に逆らうと。
Then...
恐るべき魔法の力で。
I gulp. The power will...
大事なお札を鳩に変えられちゃう。怖い!
That's just a magic trick! And they're just giving her money!
あるいは、恐怖の超能力で。
Now she's supernatural?
針を刺しても割れない風船を見せつけられちゃう。どうしたらいいの?
Oh, my phone's going off. I'm sorry about that. That just means she put a piece of tape on it! Then she pokes it where she put the tape! That keeps it from breaking!
しまいにゃ、バナナの皮を剥かずに中身をバラバラにする大イリュージョンが炸裂!
Wires! That's all wires! She cuts the insides with wires! I know you can do that! Don't underestimate the supernatural!
まあ、そういう感じ。魔法とか超能力とか呪いとか霊とか、いろいろ操れるみたいな。That's
a lot of inconsistency.
オカルトだね。
Oh, okay. There's no way any of that's real.
でも、みんなの恐怖を一心に集めてます。
That annoys me somehow.
あ、でもね。 全然授業に出てこないんだって。
She just doesn't want to go because everyone will treat her like a creep.
たまに出てくる。
Wouldn't she be kicked out for bad attendance?
アウトにならない。 どれだけ休んでも、留年もしないで退学にもならない。 なぜか。 ほとんど休んでるのに、
I see. That explains the rumor that she has tremendous authority. A light bulb appears over my head. Kotori, you don't think she really is a witch, do you? Hey, you want to go find out?
どうやって?
Let's go investigate. Like a journalist. How would I fall for someone I've never met? I haven't even seen her face. No! I just want to know who she is, since she's allegedly making a living off of some superpowers. She says it in a husky voice. I'm not proposing to her! You be quiet. Damn it, stop mocking me.
いいよ.
Huh?
してみよ、取材.
You'll help?
うん、いいよ. コタロウくんがいいと思うのなら、やればいいと思うの. それに、本当にいい出会いになるかもしんないし。
Well, that's not really... For just a moment, a merry berry deep in the back of my mind comes back to me. I guess. Thanks. I haven't sorted out my feelings at all. But for now, I just have to believe that time will fix it eventually. and then we eat lunch together. Kotori brought a bento. I have a yakisoba. As we eat, we talk about how to look for Senri Akane. Yeah, we do. She's a third year after all. We never come into contact with her. Neither Kotori nor I know any third years. When you think about it, it takes a lot of courage to do that. Going to the third year's floor and asking about someone we know nothing about. We'll just have to start talking to random people like in an RPG. Stop trying to multiply, Seto. This is gonna take a lot of nerve. I wonder if Senri's actually a bully victim. Then I'll just have to use the conversationalist powers I've been practicing on Yoshino. I have no idea what you mean. Anyway, I'm not confident about that. Remember how Yoshino was acting earlier? I guess. She brings her own bento to school, but she still feels the need to steal pieces of my bread. And she takes all of it. Don't take the yakisoba out of yakisoba bread, then it's just bread! Because it's meant to go inside the bread! You. I never wanted you to eat that yakisoba. Give me that tamagoyaki in exchange. You ate my yakisoba, bitch. Give me something then. Just kimpura, Bira? That's barely appealing at all. That's not enough to change my mind. She dumps kimpura onto my bed where the yakisoba used to be. I try a bite. This is spicy. Should it be this spicy? Thanks. This is actually good. It might go well with rice. It doesn't go well with bread. Thanks. After eating. Probably. No, just two of us is a bit lonely. That might be nice, actually. People might start assuming it's true. Alright. She's no fun. Then we better hire some mercs. I might. Yoshino! Just like, Yoshi! Yoshino is sitting in his seat. I approach his desk. Yoshino, let's go on an adventure! Damn it! We need more people! Help us out! Please! Join a party with me and Kotori! I return to Kotori. Yoshino will help us in spirit! Damn it. Deep in his heart, he is our friend. In video game terms, it's like Yoshino's health bar is displayed, but he's stunned and can't really participate in the battle. Yeah, I know. Don't make eye contact, you'll get team killed. Probably. Maybe, I don't know. We decided to have the adventure without him. Okay, here's the plan for today's operation. Somewhere in the school, there's a witch, apparently. We're trying to find her. I figured she'd drop an item for us. What Higo? What Kumamoto? What Senba? Yeah, what the fuck am I doing? You played along, though. Anyway, I was imagining some kind of exercising tools.
でもどうして除霊?
Her casual question reminds me of that terrifying night. My wrist feels cold again. Oh! Wait, are we talking about like that one time where I fainted like a pussy because apparently some hand might have grabbed my wrist? Even if it was just a dream, something bad is happening to me. I just know it. I just thought it'd be nice to have some. Okay, I'm curious. I'm just checking. Check. Wait, teacher? I'm just checking right now. Any other questions?
Hot.
Kanbei-san, go ahead. We know she's a third year, so let's stop at going to the third year floor. We have not a moment to spare. To arms! Can we please do a mappy segment? God damn it. We head to the floor where the third year classrooms are. Well, we do have to ask our senpai a bunch of questions. This isn't like talking to NPCs in a village. Don't make it my fault. Okay, let's go. Mappy? Fuck! Oh, he looks bored. Let's try talking to him. I want to do a Mappy segment. Excuse me, could you spare a moment? This is the third year classroom! We're just trying to look for... So this is what third years are like. We're trying to find someone. Ask him about the witch. Don't know, never heard of her. Try someone else. Okay, thanks. So much for beginner's luck. What do you mean? We just ask more people. Don't know. Never heard of her. Not a clue. 3 strikes in a row. The witch isn't as famous as we thought. I would laugh if this Akane person was like Ryo from Clannad. Third year girls. That's a bit stressful. Oh, that's what you mean. Good point. We decided to focus our attention on girls. Excuse me. I've heard about it before! Instant success. Really? I've been told she's around here somewhere. She knows basically nothing. I've heard she's a third year. She is? I don't think she's in our classroom. I see. Thanks. We continue our investigation. I think I know her. I think I've heard about her. I think there have been rumors about her. None of them know any details. Do we check the in-betweeners? She's supposed to be a witch, so I guess it makes sense. Oh well, on to the next one. A charmer? Yeah, I know her. Do you know where she is? I've heard she's in the occult club. Oh, now there's some detail. Is the club active? It's not on the usual club list, but I'm pretty sure there used to be one. But I've heard a rumor that I got shut down. Yeah, I think we're onto something here. Senpai, is there anything else you could tell us about that? I don't know that much, but I've heard the club room is an empty classroom. Okay. That narrows it down a bit. We have all the information we're going to get out of the third years. An empty classroom. Okay, maybe not. This is the era of low birth rates. Our school is a mammoth, but the number of students is normal. There's plenty of money to run the place even without filling it with students. So there's a huge supply of unused classrooms. Kotori closes her cell phone. So she was right about that. Think it's because it's a research club? Either way, either they have too few members or they aren't active. For whatever reason, the occult club isn't an officially recognized club. It's quite impressive that such a small group managed to get their own classroom. They're using it without permission?
Oh, you're right. だから研究会ってなんかやらかしてるんだと思うね、私は。
This is starting to sound like a huge scoop. Maybe Inoue is actually good at this.
心当たりあり?
Nope. And now I get it. If the occult club is actually active, we just have to look for an unlocked classroom.
現在も活動してればだけど、そうだね。
Okay, we know what to do now.
ちょうど昼休みも終わりだね。
Fuck. Perfect timing. Let's head back for now.So after school finally ends, let's go! It's getting fun. Doing stuff like this, it's really fun. And not just because I made a bunch of friends. We go to the third year floor.There are lots of people walking around after school. People going to clubs, people hurrying home, people chatting with classmates. Good question. Unused classrooms, I guess. Yeah, we should. Here we go, Kotori! Mappy, please! We begin wandering around the school. We check every classroom-like location we can find.It's a path toward hell. A trial with no end in sight. We search every last nook and cranny. Damn it, can I please?
Ugh.
Our faces are pale, we groan as we walk down the halls. We look like zombies. I'm sorry. Everyone steps aside when they see us. Someone holds up a cross. It's futile. Such things won't work on us. How far have we walked?At some point, we gain control of the entire school. You completed the map of the school! And then only one place remained. This place feels kind of occulty. We arrive at a lonely hallway. It's in the far corner of the school, and since no one uses this room, there aren't any students or teachers inside. The lights are off, too.
言われてみれば、そのような印象もなきにしもあらずだね。そして…空き教室もある。任務完了の匂いがプンプンするね。
Let's check it out. I push the door. It won't open. Makes sense to be locked. I try a few more times, but it won't move. Oh! And then suddenly it does. Oh shit! Crap! Crap!
どうした?
I probably broke the door. Apparently it wasn't locked. It's wide open. I lie as I open the door.Broken parts of the lock land near my feet. Sorry. Idiot, be quiet! We can't let anyone find us! I don't break stuff that often! That was a long time ago. I barely even remember it. I've been so careful about it recently.I guess I had to mess up eventually.
公共のもの壊したら弁償なんだよ。しかも割引とかないから高いんだよ。
I've heard guardrails are quite expensive, but school doors? Also, it might have been broken before I got here.
にゃ、バキって聞こえたし。
I try picking up the metal on the floor. Part of it is twisted. There's no way this can be reused. Damn.
もしここがおかけんさんだったら、まず謝罪しないとだね。
That's a bad first impression. Not much I can do about it now, though. Hello? Anyone in here? It's dark. If there are any windows here, they're covered by curtains. Kotori runs her hands along the wall, but... Fucking shit! We both leap up in the air. Who's there?! Hello? I say toward the darkness, but no one answers. I can't feel any signs of life. But it does feel like death in here. My stupid imagination makes my body shiver. I know. That kind of made me just flinch back, too.
But どっかで聞いたような声だったような。小鳥さん、ちょっと疑問に思ってるな。
We're somewhere.
わからない。けど小鳥さん、この事件ちょっと怪しいと睨んでるな。
She steps into the darkness without fear. This is the kind of bravery you might expect from a middle-aged woman. Don't be so reckless. Do you want to get cursed?
この辺だったかな、今のは。
She seems to be feeling around the walls.
Oh, sorry.
Fucking shit! That is going to get me every time, ain't it?A scream toward the hallway.
落ち着きな。待てて、今電気をつける。
After a few seconds, the lights come on. What's this? This room is incredible. It goes way beyond the classroom. In fact, this is better than most school facilities. The what's that scream? You're right. So what was that scream?
おいでおいで。
I walk over to where Kotori beckons. She's pointing to the light switch.There's a lot of switches. There's a panel on the wall filled with dozens of switches.
これ押してみて。
I try pushing the one she indicates. Oh, I see.
スイッチを押すと録音されてた悲鳴が室内に流れるようになって
る。 That's fucked up though. That's scary. This would go on a top 10 list of most useless household appliances.
こっちのスイッチは何だろう。
Don't press it.
No.
Fucking hell! Stop pressing switches! Please stop. What do you use that for? But how would that voice help? Does it make something else happen?This thing's so pointless. This room is weird. Kotori looks sharply around the room. The eyes of a woman checking something out.
今も誰か使ってることは間違いないみたい。綺麗。
It clearly hasn't been abandoned for a decade. There isn't a speck of dust anywhere.
ちゃんと女の匂いがする。
Must be her. No way. Is that what that sweet smell is?
これはシャンプーとかソープの匂い。それとは別に、ちゃんと女っぽいよ。
Tell me more. I want to smell it.
この子にはわからぬこと。
Of course. Damn it, I'm so curious! I want to smell!
目的忘れてないかい?
Yes. You're right. So this place used to be a classroom, but she's renovated the hell out of it.
冷蔵庫あるし。あ、これソファーベッド?エアコン、加湿器、テレビ、ゲーム。
Fucking hell, that sounds like Takumi and Chaos here, converting his fucking... converting his storage warehouse into a bedroom.
プレジデントチェア。
Leans back.
高級サーバーマッスン、これ欲しいよ。
Hugs.
なんか、準備室スペースにトイレと浴室があるよ。
Ten smile.
完全防音っすか。
Hits the walls.
案の定カラオケマシンだ。
Just found it.
これがダイソンの最新式全自動ロボット掃除機。
Pokes the silver disc.
カプラ箱買いかい。しょぼ。
Pulls a box out from under the desk. She runs circles around the room, pulls all sorts of things out to inspect them. Every few seconds, she lets out a cute scream.
秘密基地みたい。すごい文明開花。
This is more than just expensive. Is she secretly in charge of the school or something?
はい、質問。
Yes, Kanbei-san?
結論。ここ住める。
That's not a question. But I've got to admit, if I knew of a club with this much stuff, I'd gladly resign my position in the going home club. A new question comes up. Do you think the occult club will be capable of getting all this? There's no way you can do this without the school's help, right?This feels more appropriate for the President Club, the Fortune 500 Club, or maybe the Rockefeller Club.
どんな部?
But based on the books I see around here, this is definitely occult-centric. The bookshelves are filled with books about that stuff.
それか魔女さん、 よっぽど儲けてるかだね。
You think so?
大物政治家とか越後屋がお菓子持ってお伺いに来てたりして。
Ah, you're right. Those bright yellow tea cakes.
性的に呪いをかけるとか、未来を予知するとか。
Unfortunately, that's actually plausible.
どうする？ご本尊いないみたいだけど。
It's already evening. If she's not here now, she probably won't show up anytime soon.
メモでも置いとく？すぐ連絡くださいって書いてさ。
There is a pile of sticky notes on the table. Might as well. That should do it. We're looking for the witch of the school. We'd like you to contact us. And I'm sorry for breaking your door.
物壊しちゃって。
Hey, at least we're saying sorry. Normally, mysterious girls like this are the kind to heal you with kindness.
こんな悪趣味なのに?
I lose confidence.
あ、もうこんな時間だ。帰ろ?
Yeah. Still, this room is kind of insane. It feels like there's a big secret hiding here.
ほら、電気消しまうよ。
Okay.I spend the night alone in my big house. My parents haven't come home for weeks because of work. It's pretty fun living, sort of, on my own. But there have been a few minor problems recently. Okay, everything's locked. I lock all the doors and windows. My defenses are perfect. Against physical intruders. Anyway, I get into bed. I don't really want to turn the lights off. I like to leave them on. But I can't sleep with the lights on.Darkness covers the room. I cover my face with a blanket. I immediately become terrified. I pull my phone into bed and start calling Kotori while feeling sorry for bothering her. She picks up on the third dial. Hello, Kotori, I love you! Gooby. She was asleep. That's weird. Why did she answer the phone? Is she sleep answering?
もう食べられないよ。
She speaks legendary lines? Yeah. That's kind of mean. I see, humans can't hide their true feelings when they're asleep. This is my chance. Okay, let's talk about love. Who does Kanbe Kotori-san like most?Okay, what do you like in a guy? That's evil! I mean, that's pretty mean! He wasn't exactly malicious, so I corrected myself. Still, she really has no hopes or dreams, does she? You're cheap.What about love? To me, that's most important. You should care more about that. A wife needs to love her husband. Your kids will end up heartless. This is turning serious real quick. Is she just taking feminine modesty a little too far? I don't want to leave that alone. But I have no idea what I can say to her about it.Kotori asked me something in her sleep. What? It? What's she talking about? So it's all about money for you. I have no words left. 1 kilogram of fat, 2 kilograms of fat, 3 kilograms of fat...Enjoy your dreams of getting fat. Talking to someone got rid of most of my fear. I should be able to sleep no problem now. In fact, I can feel sleep's gentle embrace right now. I can actually feel an embrace. It's like a real woman is holding me. Oh god. This must be a dream. A dream. This got creepy. Sleep has a strange smell, actually. Almost like a rainforest. There's just no way. I almost fell asleep, but that tinge of anxiety makes my eyes open. Oh god. Holy shit! There is someone in my bed! There is someone in my bed! Holy shit, there is someone in my bed! There is someone in my bed! There is someone in my bed!
Shut up!
What?! You don't do that! What?! You don't just end like that! You don't end like that! There was someone in my bed! There was someone in my fucking bed! There was someone in my bed! You don't do that! Return to my menu! You don't do that! You don't just leave me on a cliffhanger when someone's in my fucking bed! Oh my god, that was- okay, I'll admit, that was like the best ending ever to a fucking day! You just- It's like you're probably sleeping and you feel like someone's embrace and it's like, ah, that feels so nice. And then you'll get that CG of someone in your bed and I'm like, ah! What the fuck? You don't do that! When the fuck did this game suddenly get creepy? Okay, I think I'm done. I'm done. We went through a day. But yeah, so that was Rewrite Part 3. Things got creepy at the end. Anyway, so I guess in the next video we'll be like checking out this Akane person, the witch. And yeah, so thank you for watching and I hope to see you guys again on the next part of Rewrite. So, see ya!